Good afternoon, sir. Today we are going to talk about the topic context-free grammar and context-free languages. I am Disha. So let's begin. So let's start with the overall discussion, like what is context-free grammar and context-free languages. So in formal language theory, a language is defined as a set of strings of symbols that may be constrained by specific rules. Similarly, the written English language is made up of group of letters or words separated by spaces. A valid or accepted sentence in the language must follow particular rules, the grammar. A context-free language is a language generated by a context-free grammar. They are more general and include regular languages. The same context-free language might be generated by multiple context-free grammars. The set of all context-free languages is identical to the set of languages that are accepted by pushed-out automata, PDA. Next slide. Now, coming to the book definition of CFG and CFL. So, first we have a context-free grammar. Okay, so coming to the book definition of CFG and CFL. So, first we have a context-free grammar is a four-tuple VERS, where V is a finite site called the variables. E is a finite site destroyed from V called the terminals. R is a finite set of rules, with each rule being a variable and string of variables and terminals. And S belongs to V, is the start variable. The collection of languages associated with the context-free grammars are called the context-free languages. Characteristics of CFL. Now, the class of context-free languages generalizes over the class of regular languages. That is, every regular language is a context-free language. The reverse of this is not true. That is, every context-free language is not necessarily regular. For example, as we will see, 0 to the power k or 1 to the power k, where k is more than or equal to 0, is context-free but not regular. Many issues and questions we asked for regular languages will be the same for context-free languages, such as machine model, PDA, pushdown automata, descriptor, CFG, context-free grammar, pumping lemma for context-free languages, and CFL's limit, closure of context-free languages with respect to various operations, algorithms, and conditions for finiteness or emptiness. Some analogs that don't hold, example, non-determinism in a PDA makes a difference, and in particular, deterministic PDAs define a subset of a context-free languages. We will only talk on non-deterministic PDA here. So, context-free languages allow us to describe non-regular languages like 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n, where n is more than or equal to 0. General idea is that CFL are languages that can be recognized by automata that have one single step, where 0 to the power n and 1 to the power n, where n is more than or equal to 0, is a CFL, and 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n, and 0 to the power n, where n is greater than or equal to 0, is not a CFL.
Now we'll discuss about the closure properties of context-free languages. The context-free languages are closed under union. The context-free languages are closed under concatenation. The context-free languages are closed under clean closure. The context-free languages are not closed under intersection and complement, is an important point. The family of regular languages is a proper subset of the family and family of context-free language. Each context-free language is except by pushdown automata or automation. Now, important points to remember, to just discuss the above points in a more example way. If L1 and L2 are two context-free languages, then L1 unit L2 is also a context-free language. L1 dot L2 is also a context-free language. L1 star and L2 star are also context-free languages. L1 intersection L2 is not a context-free language. not a contextual language, which comes into the fourth one we discussed. L1 complement and L2 complement are not contextual languages. Now let's talk about CFL and CFG in more detail. Informally, contextual language is a language generated by a contextual grammar. Informally, a contextual grammar consists of a set of replacement rules, each having a left-hand side and right-hand side LHS and RHS. Two types of symbols, variables and terminals. LHS of each rule is a single variable, no terminals. RHS of each rule is a string of zero or more variables and terminals. A string consists of only terminals. Here are some examples of CFG. Determiner implies A, determiner implies the verb phrase, verb adverb, verb phrase implies verb means verb is a drive, verb eats, adverb slowly, adverb frequently, all that, and many more. Now, Disha will discuss this first MCQ.
The question is, which of the following pairs have different expressive power? Now, we have four options. This is a GATE level question, and we got this in 2011 in GATE. The four options are deterministic finite automata, DFA, and non-deterministic finite automata, NFA. Then, in second option we have, which is the correct one, deterministic pushdown automata DPDA and non-deterministic pushdown automata NPDA. The third option, deterministic single tape Turing machine and non-deterministic single tape Turing machine. And in the fourth option, we have single tape Turing machine and multi tape Turing machine. So as we know that the second option is true, which is deterministic pushdown automata DPDA and non-deterministic pushdown automata NPDA, it is true because NPDA can handle languages or grammars with ambiguity, but DPDA cannot handle languages with ambiguity and any context-free grammar. Now, the second MCQ question will be discussed by Harsh.
So in the second question, we are basically talking about the closure properties, which is intersection and union on that. The question is, if L1 is equal to L1 intersection L2, where L1 and L2 are languages as defined below, we can see L1 is equal to A to the power M, B to the power M, C, A to the power N, B to the power N, M, where M and N is greater than or equal to 0. This is the assumption. L2 is equal to A to the power Y, B to the power J, C to the power K, where I, J, K are positive. Then what is L? Option A is non-recursive, option B is regular, option C is contextual but regular, option D is recursively enumerable but not contextual. We got this question in GATE CS, in the CS section in 2009. So why is the answer contextual but not regular? The language L1 accepts string C, A, B, C, A, B, C, A, B, A, B, B, C, A, B, A, B, A, B, B, C, A, B, B, and so on. And L2 accepts strings A, B, C, A, B, A, B, C, A, B, C, A, B, B, C, and so on. Intersection of these two languages is L1 intersection L2 is equal to A to our K, B to our K, C, where K is positive, which is K is either 0 or positive, which is contextual but not regular. So now we'll discuss about the application of contextual grammar. Contextual grammar is of great practical importance. It is used for following purposes. We use it in we use it for many things, like for defining programming languages, for parsing the program by constructing syntax tree, for translation of programming languages, for describing arithmetic expression, for construction of compilers, and there are many more applications. We can discuss only a few here. So this was our presentation on contextual languages and contextual grammar. Thank you.
Very good presentation. Thank you.